But what we're going to be sharing about today is the dynamics of living a Spirit-filled life. And I'm going to do a series of that. So in the next few weeks, after John leaves, I'm going to be speaking about the dynamics of living a Spirit-filled life. So Father, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ right now, we come into your presence. And Father, we're asking you that you would open our ears, that we would hear what the Spirit is saying at the beginning of this year. Father, we want to be men and women that are called by the power of God. We want to be people that know you and know the power of the resurrection of a Christ. And Lord, we want to walk in the dynamics of that power. We want to see people healed and we want to see people set free. We want to see the name of Jesus lifted high. We want to see a move of your Spirit, my God, that will eclipse anything else that's ever been seen on this planet. My God, we want to just be available for your mighty power of God to flow into us. Folks, could you just lift up your hands right now? And could you just say to the Spirit of God, Holy Ghost, I'm available. I'm available for you to indwell me with your power and with your authority. For you to speak to me. Revealer of truth, reveal what needs to be revealed in my heart today. And we'll give you all the praise and all the glory. And everybody said, Amen. God's not called us to live a religious life. You know, a lot of Christians, we want to learn, sort of live a religious life because we're now Christians. So we learn the Christian language. So we say, you know, all the religious things. But God, I believe, calls us to live in a dynamic, powerful way. Not call us to live a religious life, it's called us to live a supernatural life, powerful life. You don't have to become religious or a fanatic to please God. There's too many fanatics, too many religious people. But God wants us to be normal. One of your greatest assets is to become normal. One of your great assets, I believe, for the unbelievers is for you to become real. Just a real person who loves God with all of his heart. Amen? That's what we've got to be. So the dynamics of living a spiritful life. And of course, God spoke early in the piece in John, in Acts rather 1:8, and says, you shall receive power when the Holy Spirit comes upon you. You shall be witnesses to me, or you shall be my witnesses. I believe that God wants us to be witnesses of his power. To be a witness, not a weak person, not a broken person, not a destroyed person, not a person that's got great needs, but to be a witness of his power flowing through your life that causes you to overcome and causes you to triumph over every circumstance, every situation that may come your way. You won't sort of stop the attack, but you can change the results. The enemy will come like a roaring lion. He will do a lot of things. But I want to tell you, our God is the roaring lion. Amen? The Bible tells us that we are surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses. When I was driving in this morning, I was just meditating on that verse. We are surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses. And I believe that the witnesses that God wants us to understand that we are surrounded with are people that are witnesses of his power. And those people are the great men and women of God, the great patriarchs, the Elijahs, the Elishas, the Davids, the great men and women of God that have lived before us, the Finneys, the Wesleys, the Kuhlmans. The great men and women, the John G. Lakes, all these people that were people that weren't just ordinary religious Christians, but they were men and women that found the dynamic power of God. They found something about the power of God that wherever they went, the Peters, the Johns, the men and women that walked up into situations and said, silver and gold I do not have, but such as I have. In other words, they understood what they had. They had the dynamic power of God in them. And they said, silver and gold we do not have, but such as I have, give I thee. In the name of Jesus of Nazareth, arise and be healed. And they spoke these words. Great a manifestation of the power of God. And today we are surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses, witnesses of his power. And today I pray as a church that we would become a church that would be so conscious, so conscious that the power of God wants to surge, wants to flow, wants to manifest itself. And God wants us to be people that would go forth and demonstrate the power of God. Amen? Is that okay to do that? How many people want that? Lift up your hands, say, I want that. I'll have that, amen? We'll talk this morning about a prophetic word that we just had. And it said there that you've got to give God the words. You've got to start to speak it. You start to speak what God says about you, not how you feel, not what you think. Because the way of success is saying, I have the power of God in me now. The power of God is resident in me now. And I can flow in that mighty power of God. I can flow in the Spirit of God. I can flow in that dynamics that God has put inside us. The Bible says you shall receive power. Power comes from the Greek word dunamis. Dynamite comes from that same word, dunamis. You shall receive explosive power. Friend, we've got to understand that this is not just a powder puff thing, but this is an explosive power that God wants to put inside of us that we can literally blast sickness from people's bodies. In the name, the Bible says, you shall lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. You shall speak, you know, and you shall lay hands on those that are demon possessed and demons will come out. You shall do all these sort of things. That is an explosive power that is on the inside of every believer. And I believe that the believer, the church, has to start to stir itself and start to acknowledge and start to speak out, this power is in me. I have power over the enemy. I can destroy the works of Satan. And you start to speak it out and things will start to happen as you start to speak what God says about you. Amen. What's in the Word? I'm not just saying, you know, what I say, it's what the Word of God says. Explosive power. It says you shall receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you. What sort of power are we talking about? Not man's power, the power that you get when you go to the gym or something like that and get big muscles. But it's you shall receive God's power. Everybody say God's power. I shall receive God's power. Come on. I shall receive God's power. It's not man's power, it's God's power. Donald Trump has been given man's power. He is now going to be the president of the United States. They say one of the most powerful men in the world. But I want to tell you, without the power of God, it will not be worth a hill of beans. He'll just become another one. But I want to tell you, if he allows the power of God to manifest itself in his life, if he allows the power of God to get around him, he could be such a dynamic man, amen? They say that he's surrounding himself with many, many godly people. I pray that those godly people will be filled with the Holy Spirit and not just a bunch of people with good ideas. Godly people can just be as religious as anybody else. All the power God possesses has been deposited in you. It says in Ephesians 3:19, it says to know the love of Christ, which passes knowledge. In other words, you've got to bypass your brain. You've got to bypass your thinking. You've got to bypass what you feel about yourself, because yourself will tell you, you are not worthy. You're not good enough to receive anything from God. If you think like that, you will stay weak and you'll stay a failure. But if you can start to say, hey, God loves me, the power of God loves me, and it passes my knowledge, it says that you may be filled with the fullness of God. Can you imagine that God wants to fill a human with his fullness? He just doesn't say, I want to give you a little measure of my fullness. I don't want to give you a little measure of my power, but I want to fill you with my fullness. I want you to have dunamis power. I want you to have dynamite power. I want you to have power that will blast every enemy that stands in front of you. I want to tell you, Jesus never ever lost a battle in his life. He won every battle, hallelujah. How many people are glad about that? I believe that this is where we're going. I believe we're going to see some great things. I believe that God's power is greater than the atomic bomb. It's greater than anything else. You've got to understand that deposited inside you by the Holy Spirit who dwells in you is this atomic power, dynamic power, amazing power. that the church of the living God really has allowed just to sit there and not use. I believe with demonic forces, you can blast them out. When we got saved, we were lost in our trespasses and sins. It tells us in Ephesians 2, chapter 1. It tells us we were lost and we were led, every one of us, by our own entice and by our lust. But I thank God that something happened to us. Amen? How many people believe something happened to you? I thank God when we got born again, something dynamic happened. It wasn't just a matter of coming to church and one minute you're just nobody and all of a sudden you become a church member. Friend, I thank God I didn't just become a church member, hallelujah. I entered into something so dynamic and so powerful and the word of God, and I believe that Paul, he understood and he said, what is this exceeding greatness of his power to us who believe, not according to you or to me, but according to the working of his mighty power, which he worked through Christ when he raised him from the dead. I want to tell you, friends, this communion celebrate, this communion that we come around, this communion is so powerful, so dynamic, it's so big, hallelujah. What is the exceeding greatness of his power to you and to me, not according to how good I've been or according to anything else or how religious I've been or whether I've prayed for 10 hours a day or whether I've done this or that, but according to the working of his mighty power, which he worked in Christ, hallelujah. I want to tell you, Jesus wasn't on any holiday when he came on this planet. He was here fighting a battle. He was there destroying the works of Satan. For this purpose was the Son of God made manifest, that he might destroy the works of Satan. And everything he did was just hammering one more nail into Satan's coffin, hallelujah. Everything he did was just pulling back one more stronghold, breaking down one more barrier, doing something so dynamic and so powerful that to release us, but the church can sit around and just play lollipops and tiptoeing through the tulips with Tiny Tim when God wants us to be relentless, hallelujah. The mighty power of God, the mighty anointing of God. The anointing, the power, the victory of the cross of Calvary, amen. You shall receive power when the Holy Ghost comes upon you. What is this exceeding greatness? It's the mighty Holy Ghost power living in you that wants to explode on the inside of you, that wants to impregnate your life. Your words become so powerful. Do you know that your words are powerful? Words are mighty, hallelujah. They're powerful. The exceeding greatness of his power to us who believe. According to the working of his mighty power. That's Ephesians 1:19. This power, this dunamis towards us, the same power that raised Christ from the dead and destroyed the works of Satan, is now flowing to the church, the believer. In other words, God wants to blast us out of our natural thinking into supernatural thinking. Can I say that again? God wants to blast us out of natural thinking into supernatural thinking. He wants to blast us out of the kingdom of darkness and take us into another kingdom, the kingdom of dunamis power, hallelujah. What an amazing thing God wants to deliver us out of and take us into something so dynamic. You know, one of the problems today is that we get around people. We work with a lot of people in the natural. We work with people that have opinions. And they think in the flesh. You get around a lot of Christian people, they think natural. They only think in the natural. But friend, I want to tell you, we got to get around a bunch of people that think differently, amen, that start to talk differently. I'm not talking about religious talk. I'm not just talking about gentle Jesus, meek and mild. I'm not just talking about lullabies. I'm talking about powerful things. I'm talking about saying things like, greater is he that's within me than he that's within the world. All things are possible to those who believe. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me, amen. And start to build yourself up in the Holy Ghost. Start to build the power of God inside of you. Dunamis power wants to explode, wants to deliver us out of one kingdom and take us into another kingdom. Friend, I want to tell you, too often the church, we stay in this kingdom and try to act out that kingdom. Let's get over into this kingdom. Amen. Let's be people of the Holy Ghost. Let's be the people of the fire of God. In Hebrews chapter 2, I want you to have a look at this with me. Hebrews chapter 2, verse 1. Very interesting scriptures here. Very, very interesting scriptures. Hebrews chapter 2, verse 1. Therefore, when you see a therefore in the Bible, you got to see what it's there for. God wants to get our attention. Therefore, we must give the more earnest heed to the things we have heard, lest we drift away. Church, I believe that people, we can drift away. We can drift away just so gently. Drift away. Drift away from the dynamics. Drift away from the power of God. Drift away from the reality of the church and drift away and just become another church. It says, for if the word spoken through angels proved steadfast and every transgression and disobedience received a just reward, how shall we escape if we neglect so great a salvation? How shall we escape if we neglect so great a salvation? Friend, when we were saved, we weren't just saved. Amen. We were delivered. Everybody say delivered. We were delivered out of a natural thinking person to become a dynamic supernatural person. Satan wants, if he can, to keep us, the church, thinking naturally. If you think naturally, nothing will change. If you just think naturally, friend, we are natural, yes, but I want to tell you, we've got to say natural mind. I want to submit myself to the spirit mind. My spirit says, I can do this. People say to me, Neil, you're 77 years of age. Why don't you give up? I cannot give up. I cannot give up. Hallelujah. I cannot stop. If you want to give up, but I'm not quitting. Hallelujah. If you're looking for some young pastor to come in and take over the church, I've got news for you. He ain't coming. Hallelujah. See, it also says over here, the wind's got me. 3 verse 7, it says, therefore, again, what's therefore, therefore? It's got to see what it's there for. As the Holy Spirit says, today, if you hear his voice, do not harden your hearts as in the rebellion, in the day of trial, in the wilderness, as your fathers did. Don't harden your hearts. You see, when you start preaching about what God says about us, when we start saying what God wants to do with us, dunamis power, dynamic power, he wants us to go in there and destroy and break down and smash what the enemy's doing in this world. What happens naturally, the first thing is your natural mind wants to war against the thing of the Spirit. And what happens sometimes is we can be sitting in church, listening to somebody preaching his heart out and saying, the silly old goat, what is he talking about? What's going on? Where? What? And our natural mind says that. You can say, I've been saved 30 years and I've never seen that. Well, I want to tell you, hang on to your seat, friend, because you're going to start seeing things in Jesus' name. Amen. You better hang on, because I believe if we're believing that God's coming back, he's not coming back for some sloppy church. He's coming back for a church that's moving in power and authority and has the victory in Jesus' name. Amen. I believe he's coming back for an amazing church, a powerful church, a church that we'd all want to be part of. God wants us to enter into everything that he has for us. This won't happen until we realize greater is he that's within us than he that's within the world. When you got born again, friends, something dynamic happened in your life. When you got saved, you just didn't get saved so you could go to heaven. If that was the case, we should have drowned you in the baptismal font. No, we're here to be the church. We're here to be his witness, amen. A witness of his power. A witness of his victory, what he wrought for us when he was raised from the dead. Won't happen until we realize greater is He that's within us than he that's within the world. In 2 Kings 6:8, we're talking about a man that the king was there, and they were trying to ambush him. They were trying to kill him. But there was a prophet in town, a man that knew the word of God. And he went out there and he told the king not to go that way. Don't go that way, you'll get ambushed. And the man of God there, he saved the king many times. But the king of Syria got so angry with him that he went out there and says, "Where is this man?" They said, "He's in Dothan." He sent a whole army after him. And when Gehazi got out of bed that morning and opened up the windows to do his exercises, as he opened up the window, he saw the horses and chariots of the Syrian army. And he went over to the man of God and he said, "Alas, master," he said, "it's doomed, it's finished, it's over." But I want to say this, that this man of God had such a peace, such a relentless tenacity that knew his God. Father God, to God, that we might know you, that we might know you in the power of your resurrection, that we might know you in the power of the mighty Holy Ghost that you've invested in us, that we might know you. I'm not talking about know about you. I'm talking about knowing him and having the dynamic power of God surging through your body when you lay hands on somebody and demons start screaming, hallelujah. You remember the old days, Kevin? Oh, shakarabande. I want to tell you, it's going to be double yammy rammy. It's going to be better than that ever. Oh, glory to God. The dynamic power of God that comes upon a man or a woman, that when you lay hands on somebody, sickness and disease and cancers flee from person's body. People there that have been in agony and all of a sudden are totally healed. People in wheelchairs jump up and start running around and giving glory to God. Amen. Friend, I'm talking about the dynamic power of God. Don't let your natural mind say, "What is this guy talking about? I haven't seen this. I don't care what I've seen. I don't care what I haven't seen. All I know is what the Word of God says. It says that we're going to see it again. We're going to see it again. Hallelujah. We're going to see it again. We're going to see the dynamic move of God. And I better keep hurrying. Hey, glory to God. And this Gehazi guy came up and says, "Hey, there's such and such is happening out there." And then he said, "Hey, open his eyes. I hear that word coming now. Lift up your hands. Open our eyes, Lord. Let us see in the realm of the Spirit. Let us see what Gehazi saw. Not the natural man, but let us see what the spirit man sees. The natural man sees the enemy, but the spirit man sees the army of God, hallelujah. The natural man sees the sickness, but the spirit man sees the hand of God, sees the mighty provision of God. The natural man sees the problem, but the spirit man sees the answer. Thank you, Jesus. Open our eyes, open our eyes, open our eyes, that we might be able to see it. Oh, Rabba Shate. But friend, I want to say this, just like that man, when the mighty baptism of the Holy Spirit is upon us, it's not the end, it's just the beginning. But we've got to speak what the Word says and not what you feel. One of our problems is that we speak what we feel. I believe that we're living in the age of the outpouring of the Holy Spirit. Do you believe that? In Ezekiel 47, the story there of a man that had a vision, had a dream. And as he was having this dream, he saw the throne of God. He saw the temple of God, the house of God. And this, by a dream or by the Spirit, is taken this to this place. And as he walked up these stairs and as he looked, he said he noticed water gushing out from underneath the door. And it went out this way. Then he went a little bit further. And as he went further, he noticed there was another water rushing out. There was a great river. Friend, I don't know about you, but there's a river that's flowing from God above. There's a river that's filled with God's love. There's a river that's filled with God's power. And this man, Ezekiel, saw this great river that was flowing out from God. And he saw this river. And it says there that a man came with a measuring rod. And as he went out and he measured 1,000 cubits. And he said he walked out into that 1,000 cubic. And it said the water was up to his ankles. And he said that the measuring rod went out at even 1,000. And he walked out again and it came up to his knees. And he said that the measuring rod went out 1,000. And he came up and it was up to his waist. And he said then the measuring rod went out 1,000, and as he went out this 1,000, he said the river, it became a river, and it was too deep, you could not cross it. It was a river that you had to swim in. And I believe, friend, that at the progression of time, that God is taking us into this river. We might have been ankle deep, we might have been knee deep, you might have been waist deep, you might have been there, but God wants to take us into the river that we're going to swim in. Hallelujah. The river of God is going to take us to a place. He saw this great river that was flowing and said, then God took him to the bank of the river. And as he looked at the bank of the river, he said there were trees. And it says wherever this river went, this river brought life. And this river went into the sea and there was great fishes there because the river's been healed. I want to tell you, I believe that the church, that God is going to flow into the church. I believe that the river of life is going to flow into the church and the church is going to get healed. Hallelujah. And the church is going to come alive. It's going to burst into life. Hallelujah. Because there's going to be an abundance of fishes. I don't know about you, but he said to Peter, I'm going to make you a fisher of men. I don't know about you, but I believe there's going to be a great gathering. The church is going to be revived. There's going to be a great power of God. But I believe that this river, this mighty river, was also described in Joel 2:28. Why don't you have a quick look with me in that? I think you know it very well. You go to this church, you will anyhow. Who's got Joel? You got it up there. And it shall come to pass. Everybody say, it shall come to pass. This is prophesied. It shall come to pass. Afterward, I will pour out of my spirit on all flesh. Your sons and your daughters shall prophesy. Your old men shall dream dreams. Your young men shall see visions. And also on your maidservant and on your men servant, I will pour out my spirit in those days. Goes on and says, I'll show wonders in heaven and so forth and so forth. What an amazing statement. What an amazing thing here. Joel starts to speak it. The Bible also says in John 7:31, Jesus said, out of your belly will flow rivers of living water. This spake he of the Holy Spirit. I believe that these three events are all linked together. I believe that this is what happened. Joel prophesied about it. Ezekiel saw it in a vision. The disciples experienced it. I don't know about you, but I can feel it coming on now. Hallelujah. I don't know. There's a stirring going on, friends. If you're not getting stirred, I want to tell you, you need an injection. I sense a stirring of the Holy Ghost. I sense there's something about to happen. Hallelujah. I believe here that we see that these guys, there Ezekiel, Joel prophesied what was going to happen. Ezekiel saw it in a vision and the disciples experienced it. Ezekiel saw a river of life. Everybody say a river of life. Out of your belly shall flow rivers of life. River, see, wherever your voice goes. The river of life is in your voice. It will bring forth life. We need to get with people and start to talk with them. I can remember recently going to a shopping center and these couple of old people were sitting beside us. They were old. I was young compared to them. They're much really younger than me. Man, we're sitting there talking and they started talking and grumbling about a few things. And next minute, we just started to share. And as we shared, this lady got so excited because she was drinking from the well. You are a well of living waters. But if you stop up your well, if you don't talk, nothing will change. I want to tell you, you've got to get out into places. You've got to sit down in the shopping centers, wherever it is, and you've got to find somebody and you've got to tell them about Jesus. Because you've got a river of life inside you. Oh, you guys are going to get that village saved. Hallelujah. You dynamo, the three, what is it called? Rope can't be broken. What a dynamic power. Dynamic duo. Hallelujah. Ooh, dunamis power. Come out, you three. Come out here quick. I just feel to do this. Quick. Quick, 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 quick. Come on, don't worry about anything. Dynamic duo. Okay. Just hold hands. Hey, you ready? You ready for this? You ready? Let the power! Dunamis power! All over, amen. Take that village in Jesus' name. There's more for where that come from. The power of God, hallelujah. In Acts chapter 2, speaks about a sound. Let's have a look at Acts. Is anybody else having fun here, or am I the only one? Acts. It's all right, just stay there for a while. Take it, drink it up. Come on, drink it up, take it up. You dynamic duo. Who are you? Dynamic duo. You look at you. The dynamic duo, look at them. Shakabundi. It says here in chapter 2 of the book of Acts, it says, when the day of Pentecost had fully come, they were all in one accord in one place, and suddenly there came a sound from heaven as of a rushing mighty wind, and it filled the whole house where they were seated. It came as a mighty sound. Sorry, let me read it again. Suddenly there came a sound from heaven as of a rushing mighty wind. Can I say this? I don't believe that it was necessarily a wind that they could see. If it would have been a mighty rushing wind, it would have been a tornado, it would have wrecked the whole place. But I've had the privilege of going to Niagara Falls, and you can hear the sound, the roar of that river from miles and miles and miles away. When you can hear it and you're drawn to that sound, there's a roar going on. There's a roar that's happening in the realm of the Spirit. And this river that does roar, I believe that what was happening here in the book of Acts is that as the disciples received that thing, it was like that river that was flowing, the mighty river of God flowing into the church, flowing into God's people, flowing in like a mighty river. And it says, and when this sound occurred, the multitude were gathered. I want to tell you, there's a sound that God wants to create in every one of us. There's a sound of praise, there's a sound of worship. We touched a little bit this morning, but I want to tell you, it's nothing compared to what God wants to touch in our lives, what God wants to do in our lives. I believe that there's a powerful river that wants to flow into us. This powerful river of God will never be bound by religious concepts, by denominational rule, by political correctness. We had a move of the Spirit in 93 that flowed like a mighty river. Kevin and Bev, I believe, would have been part of that. Kevin would have certainly been part of it. That just came as a mighty rushing river. Just something from the realm of the Spirit. No man could put his name on it. No man could say, I did that. No man could say anything about it. It was just there that we were just in one accord, in one place, ready to enter into a meeting. It was the first meeting. I raised my hand to say something, and as I did, the whole house, everybody in the place got slain in the Spirit, and they began to laugh and roll on the floor. It was just a move of the Spirit. But you see, what happened after that, when we all got touched by it, man tried to contain it. Man tried to explain it. Man tried to control it. Man tried to make it happen. But I want to tell you, you cannot. This river that God is going to flow in, no man is going to say, this is mine. Can I say this to you, friend? You might come to this church, but you do not belong to this church. You belong to the church. Amen. I don't care today, every person who is born again, whether they're Catholic, whether they're color thumping, Methodist, Presbyterian, I don't know if they love Jesus, they belong to the church. Hallelujah. We belong to a church. We might come here from time to time, but I want to tell you, we belong to something greater. Hallelujah. Amen. And I believe the river of God is going to flow into the great church, amen. And there's going to be signs and wonders and miracles, and there's going to be great things happening. What an amazing thing. I want to tell you, they've put denominational walls. I pray that Global Connections' name would be totally obliterated, that just, we are nobodies, hallelujah. We're just part of a body of Christ, amen. We belong to Jesus. I want to tell you, no denomination can control it. There's no political corrections. Walls can't contain it. The river will rise till we can't resist it any longer. It will take us till we flow in the supernatural power of God Himself. It's not a time to draw back, folks. Don't remain quiet. Come out. Swim in the river. Swim. I remember when that Holy Ghost come down, Kevin would remember this too. We went to the church up here at, because we were, I don't know where we were, but anyhow, we went up there. Mumbai. And Ivan Nosworthy was standing on the platform. And I think they had blue carpet at the time. Your brother. And he looked at it and it looked like water. You remember it well. So he just dived off the platform. He did. He just dived straight in. Everybody thought he'd kill himself. He just dived straight in. And much to our surprise, he came up doing the breaststroke. Then he started freestyle. It was the most hilarious thing I've ever seen. He had the breathing pip. This river is rising. The river is rising. It's going to take us somewhere. It's going to take us somewhere. Are you ready? It's not a time to put your little floaties on. It's time to swim. Time to swim in the river. Swim in the river. Where's the musicians? Time to swim in the river. If you need a touch, if you need a stir, if you need to loosen up a bit, why don't you get yourself out the front? Why don't you let the Holy Ghost come upon us? Let's stand to our feet.
Come on.
There is a current stirring deep inside. It's overflowing.
Come on, get that stir.
Rising, rising. We come alive.